Hello, Hooded Kobold in the flesh. So in this video, I want to try something a little new. I want to change up the format. So currently we've been using kind of a narrative format, and I want to change it to more of a guided tour format. So you'll get a little less detail in the story, but in exchange for that, I want to give the interactions that happen between me and the players, and then also some of the thoughts that happened, you know, in my head while I'm running the campaign. So if this is something that you do not like, please let me know. Go grab your pitchforks, and then go down in the comments below and let me know that you prefer the narrative format. If you do that, what I will do is I will remake episode 4 in the narrative format, and then from here on out, I'll keep making it in the narrative format. So with that, we'll back to the digital world.
In our Waterdeep Dragon Heist campaign, the heroes finally got their manor livable, even though it still has a ghost in it. They also got to do a little exploring around the town, meeting a couple faction leaders, and even joining a couple factions. They were also given a plethora of quests to help them start rising in their respective factions. Today, though, is a pivotal moment for Jek, and later in the adventure, you'll find out why. The Zhentarim had recently reached out to Furcuti and Pickles, asking them to find out who is killing the elves at night in the Dock Ward. Davos Starsong is the faction leader, and he wants them to find out who is doing this and deal with them. The Zhentarim kinda get a bad name, like they're kinda evil. I mean, their goals are to amass wealth, power, and influence, so I get it. I think it's best to think of them as an exclusive group that's focused on helping each other out, but no one else. The Zhentarim also goes by another name. They call themselves the Black Network. So if you hear me saying that in the series, just know that those two are interchangeable. The next faction was the Order of the Gauntlet, a group focused on finding and ridding the world of evil. It only makes sense that they would reach out to Karis, who is already a member of the Watch. They reached out to her, asking her to stop some fights that are breaking out in the Field Ward. With the rising violence in the city, the Gauntlet is worried about their lack of order in the city and wants to make sure that the law keeps its grip. She was also bothered by another group, the Lords Alliance, also known as LA for all the hip people, is focused on strengthening the coalition of the four major cities along the Sword Coast: Silvery Moon, Baldur's Gate, Neverwinter, and of course, Waterdeep. Jarlaxle Silvermane is the representative for the Lords Alliance. He has asked her to protect one of the guilds in Waterdeep, who has recently paid for protection when they do their work at the dock. Our last faction is the Harpers, a cloak and dagger faction focused on protecting the vulnerable and destroying those who use their power for evil. They are currently trying to find any Zhentarim operatives working in Waterdeep. They had asked Jek to find Mackenzie, one of their operatives, and a freaking talking horse, to see what she had found out. The most surprising request came from Blackstaff herself. She asked the group to speak to Monk Halam, who lives on Mount Waterdeep. She said that he has much wisdom, and she would like them to report all that he has back to her. Karis woke up early that morning because she wanted to get to the Dock Ward before the Dung Sweepers got there. Guys, it happened again! When she walked downstairs, the tavern had been completely rearranged. Tables were upside down, dishes had been pulled out of their drawers. The place was a total mess.
We need to get that ghost out of here!
The poltergeist who lived in their house had struck again. It seemed to take every opportunity it had to cause them grief. Karis left, leaving the others to clean up the tavern. As she closed the tavern doors behind her, she saw a lady walking up to the tavern.
Howdy, my name is Valletta, priest to the House of the Inspired Hands.
Valletta is a dragonborn, a large humanoid with thick bronze scales and a face of a dragon, but standing on two legs, like humans and elves. Valletta had come to tell the players about the temple and to let them know about their recent breakthrough in robotics, hoping to make a sale. She also informs Karis that her neighbors are suspicious of the heroes. Valletta shows Karis the blood that is painted on the neighbors' doors, along with scratch marks. Rumors were starting that the heroes were were-rats and were planning on destroying the neighborhood. She also slyly slipped in that the House of the Inspired Hands had just released a new model of their automatrons. These were robotic humanoids created to assist with many different tasks, allowing their masters more free time to do things they wanted to do. Karis bid Valletta a good day, not really giving it a second thought, and headed to her post. All the other heroes had also woken up and started to head out to their respective jobs.
Out of game, I was like, you guys want to go to work?
They were like, yeah, I gotta make that Skrilla to pay for all our new stuff. I had been using the rules for expenses in the player's handbook. I think they were using modest living, so they were bleeding a gold a day. This would cover keeping up their equipment, eating well, etc. From here, we decided to break the sessions into day and night cycles, where they would work during the day, earning enough money to cover their expenses, got those guild fees and manor to fix up, and earning a little extra on top of that. Lucky for Karis, though, she got to do a little guild work while she worked. She worked in the dock ward and guarded the dung sweepers that day. It was very relaxed and nothing really happened. After they got off their jobs, they came back to discuss their next moves.
I want to make cheese and beer!
Jack zoomed past Pickles and headed straight for his room, not seeming interested in the topic. Fricuti excitedly jumped in with Pickles.
Yeah, we should get some supplies and start right now!
Karis agreed to help, and as they headed down the stairs into the cellar, they heard a tap at the door. When they opened the door, they were greeted by four halflings.
Can we help you?
We heard that you reopened Trollskull Manor, and thought you might be looking for staff to keep your place running. We can cook, and clean, and serve your guests. We are so lucky! Can we keep them, Karis? Can we?
Well, we do need staff to run the bar while we're away. And that easy, the heroes had four new employees, and this was definitely not a trap, at all. Our heroes showed the halflings the place, and told them to come back soon, once they had opened the bar.
Are you serious? Again?
What's bothering him?
The thing bothering Jack was his patron. Since he was a warlock, he had a patron, and he took the Great Old One, the player liking all things Lovecraft. The problem was that his patron was demanding, requiring him to kill a living creature each day since they had been sent to rescue Floon. And our last session was the first time that he didn't kill someone, and his patron was furious, threatening to remove his powers from him if he didn't make it up to him.
You will have your death tonight.
He went downstairs and headed into the streets, off for some nefarious deeds. Fricuti and Pickles planned to start their stakeout to find the person who had been murdering the elves at the dock ward. After hours of walking about, they hear a scream. They run over and see an elf who is stabbed, laying on the ground. Out of the corner of their eyes, a blur leaps onto the roof awning and starts to climb. Get him! Fricuti shoots frost out of his hands, narrowly missing the figure. The figure finishes its climb, pulls out a flintlock pistol, whips around, and shoots Fricuti. Now we have a chase. In the Dungeon Master's Guide, Chapter 8, we see the rules for a chase. Pickles now starts climbing, Fricuti is already on the roof, and Stabby McStabberson is running along the roofs. It's Fricuti's turn. He shoots and hits with his ray of frost. I think to myself, this chase is getting pretty good. Fricuti's player lets me know that now that he was hit with the ray of frost, his speed drops by 10 feet. Externally, for the player, I'm excited, but internally, I'm conflicted. I let the heroes know as they get closer, they notice the shadowy figure is a drow. Then, before they can get too close, he casts darkness and disappears. So this is where I feel like I was a bad DM. I had fallen into this pit trap where I, the DM, think something is super cool and I expect it to happen. And then when the heroes do their own cool thing that conflicts with mine, I try to subvert them. I really wanted this guy to get away. It adds mystery and something else for the players to look for later. In hindsight, I should have just let the heroes catch him and played it from there, giving the players the satisfaction that they had earned. Pickles and Fricuti, unable to find the drow, head back to the elf, who is barely alive. Fricuti heals him and asks what happened.
I was just attacked. I didn't even know I was stabbed until I was on the floor.
The night was getting late, so they decided to head back home after they made sure the elf was fine. They would get some rest and then check with Davil Starsong, the Zhentarim leader, tomorrow. When they had got back home, there was a note outside their door.
What is that?
It looks like a letter from Davil. You guys have done well. There's a shop in the trades ward called the Weird Bottles Concoction. A gnome who runs it is a friend of ours, named Schemo. He's made some potions of mind reading for a client. Pick up the potions and deliver them to the Godcatcher, one of them enormous statues in the castle ward. Give the potions to the lady in the purple cloak, and keep the tip. I guess we have our orders for tomorrow. Just then, Jack came walking up from behind.
Move.
He was covered in blood. They all looked at the blood, and then to Jack's face.
These rats here are huge.
He pushed past them and headed to his room. And that's where our adventure ends for now. In our next episode, we will find out about Jack and his dark deeds done dirt cheap. Karis will have to rise to the occasion to protect someone, and Fricuti and Pickles will fall further down the Zhentarim rat hole. Thank you guys for listening. Again, please use the comment section below to let me know if you like this new guided tour format, or if you want me to go back to a more narrative one. Thank you. Bye-bye.